Morning, everyone. Why don't you stand with me, will you? Today's Backpack Sunday. We're going to have a great time. We're going to give away backpacks. Some of the folks from Children's Ministry are going to do the whole thing. I get to sit back and sing and relax. Now, there's a rule this morning, though. We're doing like a kids' service. It's kind of like super church. So you have to act like a kid. All right? All those old people, all you old people, all those things that you just watch little kids do and you think, boy, I know, I've heard some of you say, man, I wish I had that energy again. Well, this morning you get to have it one time for a couple hours this morning, all right? And we're going to sing some songs and we're going to have some fun. Before we do that, we're going to pray. And we're going to ask the Lord to help us. We've got a couple of things we need to remember. Brother Foster's going to start treatments here, and we need to remember him. Cindy Williams had surgery this week, and she is doing well, but not well enough to leave the house, so we need to pray for her. And then just everybody else that we know, if there's somebody traveling that we don't see this morning, Brother Zane is at Point of Hope. They finally got their church done, and he's there helping them get sound all done, so we need to remember him. Brother Odell's working. Pray that he survives this heat. It's going to cool down next week. And then we're going to pray for our service this morning that the Lord will help us, all right? Amen. Will you pray with me? Will everybody pray? Kids, will you pray? Will you close your eyes and lift your hands and let's talk to the Lord for a minute? Let's pray. God, we love you. We magnify your name. We thank you for your goodness. We thank you for our children. God, we pray this Sunday for your protection on them. Keep your hand on them while they're at school, God. Watch over them. Keep them. Help them to show the love of God to people that don't know the love of God. We pray for those in our church that are sick that you'd heal them. Keep your hand on those that are traveling. Watch over Brother Odell working today. God, we believe you and we trust you. You're our provider. You're our keeper and our savior, and we love you. We thank you for your goodness and your mercy. We thank you for your presence that we already feel in this place today. And we ask in the name of Jesus that you'd help every one of us today be everything you want us to be. Amen. You can be seated. Before we get started, we're going to ask the ushers to come. They're going to wait on you for tithe and offering. As soon as we're done with tithe and offering, they're going to take over. And I don't know what's going to happen, but we're going to have fun. Praise God. Brother Foster, ask God to bless the offering this morning. Amen. Give to the Lord and he'll bless you today.
Are you glad to be in church this morning? Amen. Are y'all awake? Well, we're going to start a song while they get ready. And I need a hallelujah side and a praise ye the Lord side, okay? So when I say hallelujah, you all stand up. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Seated.
Of the spirit, because the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. team has most balls on their side. You
so, want to get rid of them. You don't want them to be on your side.
Transition to the next thing. While they're doing that, I've got some announcements I need to make. The prime timers. We have age-specific ministries in our church. So prime timers are the young married couple. So if you're out of college to 50, I know that's not old necessarily. I think that's young. I'm 58, so that's still pretty young. So our prime timers are married couples with families. That group is having an outing, a pitch-in, August 10th at the Ragsdales. There is a sign-up sheet at the Welcome Center through the hall and over there. So if you're 22, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, and you haven't hit 50 yet, you're part of the prime timers. And they're going to have a big cookout. Zane's got a great big smoker. They're going to smoke a bunch of meat. They're going to have a great time. So prime timers, you have an outing on August 10th, and there is a sign-up sheet, and you need to sign up for that, all right? Next Sunday is the last Sunday of the month. That will be our hyphen group. Hyphen is that college and career age, when you're in college and you're not a teenager anymore, but you haven't settled down and bought a house. You're collecting bills at that point in your life, all right? So if you're in the hyphen, they go out the last Sunday of the month. They go out to eat every Sunday after church, all of them together. We have a class for them upstairs, and on that last Sunday of the month, they go out and eat, all of them together, and so they'll have a great time next Sunday. This afternoon at 5, today at 5 o'clock in the fellowship hall. We're having a ministry mentoring class. If you are in my ministry mentoring class, we are having class today at 5.
Amen.
Tuesday is our new members class. If you have questions about our church, you don't know what we believe, or you'd be interested in finding out things about coming to our church and becoming a member of our church, we have a class on Tuesday nights at 7:30. It's also in the fellowship hall. And that class is open to anyone that wants to come. And we'd be happy to have you join us Tuesday night at 7:30. Thursday's our midweek service at 7:30. We meet here. We sing and worship together, and then we go out. And we have different classes all through the building for different age groups. Each age has a class on Thursday night. I'm teaching a series right now. I'll be in the second week of the seven ships that it requires for us to sail and navigate through life properly. This last week, we taught on the first ship. I'm going to teach on the second ship this coming Thursday night at 7:30. All right? So we're busy. We keep a lot of things going on. But that keeps us active and living for God and doing what God wants us to do. Don't forget primetimers. It's essential for you that you sign up to go on that hour. And then next Saturday, big deal next Saturday, the Overcomers are having Overcomers are having a big garage sale in the gym. So if you were going to help them bring it, put it in that closet up front. That thing's packed full of stuff right now. If you are into bargains and want to bargain shop, you can come Saturday morning and see what they've got going on. I'm glad the road's open. Yeah. Yeah. I'm so glad the street's back open. Thank God they got all that done, and now then you can easily navigate back and forth down Sunnyside. So everything will be back to normal this week, all right? I think that's all the announcements that I have. Are they ready in the back? They are ready in the back. So we're going to let them go again.
Lately I've been reeling, watching the nightly news. Don't seem to find the rhythm, just wanna sing the blues. Feels like a song that never stops. joy, 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 joy down in my heart, down in my heart to stay.
Joy. God should be suggested. I don't know, something to damn religion and his God.
Remember,
Daniel was sitting in the window. He used to be praying just like you.
Yes, our plan has worked. Quick, let's go tell the king. Did you not make a law saying that anyone who prayed to any god or man except you each 30 days should be thrown to the lions?
Yes, I did. Wait a minute. You were the ones who suggested that I make such a law.
Well, Daniel, who is one of the Jews captured and brought to Babylon years ago, takes no notice of the law. He's still praying to his god three a day.
Daniel, how did this happen? I must find some way to change the law. Daniel is one of my favorite leaders. I must put an end to this law.
It's now evening, and you must decide what to do about Daniel. You must carry out the law as you wrote it.
Yes, Daniel must be punished to show others that he has broken your law. You must be taken to the lion's den.
Yes, that is true. I have no choice. Daniel is to be brought to the lion's den.
Ha ha ha! your seat. Sit down a minute. Thank you, parents. If you ever want to do anything for your children, say a prayer for them.
Amen.
They're covered in prayer. There's nothing more important for them to know that.
Amen.
In the world we live in today, it's so wicked, and things happen everywhere we go. Let them know that mom and dad's home praying for them. So today we're going to give backpacks away. Got lots planned for the next half an hour, or like 2 hours. Face painting lady is here. We got backpacks to give away. I know it's expensive for children to go to school.
Amen.
And so we're going to do this kind of organized. I want all of you that are in kindergarten to third grade to stand. Kindergarten to third grade. Stand up. Kindergarten to third grade. We're going to let the girls go first. Girls, your backpacks are right here. Come pick out a backpack. Kindergarten to third grade. Anywhere down here. Any of these backpacks you can. Kindergarten to third grade. They have a few supplies. They're not all that they need, but a few supplies. Kindergarten to third grade. Girls first. Okay, now our boys, kindergarten to third grade. Then here, you don't. Mom and dad, there is a tag on there that you can write your name on it, write your bus number and the teacher's name. It also has a Precious Life Daycare in Lawrence Episcopal Church in case you forget where to come on Sunday morning. Has an address. And you're welcome every Sunday at 11 o'clock. Kindergarten to third grade boys. Kindergartners in third grade get one. Any of our preschoolers, 3 and 4 year olds, want to come and get a backpack? 3 and 4 year olds, come on up. Thank you.
Usually they do all this in their Sunday school class. But this is the Sunday before school starts in most of the school districts around us. So if you're sitting near a kid, a child that's going to school, stay in here, guys. Stay in here. If you're sitting near a child, I want you to focus on that child that you're sitting near. And I want you to take that child and pray for them every day this school year. All right? I want you to remember one of them. I want you to get their name. And I want you to call out their name every day, because they're going into schools that are teaching things that we don't believe. And they're hearing things that are not going to help them and be good for them. Some of them are going into lions' dens. And they need God to protect them and help them. We're going to pray. We're going to pray and ask God to bless that food, but we're going to remember our children. We're going to pray that God's hand of protection will be on them all year long. All right, let's pray together. God, we love you. Father, we thank you for all your blessings. We thank you for all your goodness to us. We thank you for every one of these children that you have entrusted into our care. And we pray today in the name of Jesus that you'll watch over them and keep your hand upon them. Help something that we've said in our church or in our daycare. God, let it be a benefit to them in their lives, we pray. Pray for your protection, God, your hand of mercy on them. Help them to be a light in a dark world, and help them to be an example of the goodness of Jesus Christ to people that don't know you. Pray today also, God, for this food as we return thanks for the food. Pray that you would bless it to the nourishment of our bodies. Help us to have a good time and to love you in everything that we say and do, and we'll be quick to praise you in Jesus' name. Everybody said amen. Amen. You are dismissed. You can go back that way and follow the crowd, and there'll be plenty.